Students, I was talking about the sense of vision. So in previous video we saw about the hawk. I give an example for hawk. So next, some insects is also having a sense of vision. So very good sense of vision. So such type of insects are ants, flies, bees, honeybee, all those things have large compound eyes. So what is this feature in these insects? They have large compound eyes. So what is the meaning of compound eyes? So it is made up of thousands of micro eyes. So I think you are familiar with a CC camera, right? In CC camera we have many micro cameras, compound cameras. So if you see in a computer screen, so it is visible, yes or no? If we in CC camera surface, if we see a spotted cameras also in a computer screen, we see only one. Okay, such type of feature is made in these insects. So it is made up of thousands of micro eyes. So it is help for these insects, and even these flies and bees also easily spot its food in flying. So if it's fly very fast also, these living insects can easily access the prey or food. So this is about the insects. So apart from these insects, owl, I think you know very well, owl, it is not visible in daytime, so it is very active in night. So the large eyes, so what is the feature of owl? The large eyes helps to see in dim light, even in dark also. The large eyes helps to see in dim light, and it has very sensitive ears. So apart from the vision, it is very good in hearing also. So this, the owl having very soft, very fluffy feathers. The soft and fluffy feathers helps owl to fly very silent. Means it can maintain an extreme silent while flying. So these fluffy feathers and soft feathers helps owl to catch its prey, especially in the night. So this is about the vision. Just hold on, students. Okay, students, so far we discussed about the sense of smell and sense of vision. So if we come to hearing, sense of hearing, so bats, the whale and dolphins use the sense of hearing to catch its prey. So first we'll discuss about the bats. So I think just like an owl, so bats also very active in the night. So the usually, what is the feature of bats while catching its food or prey? So it makes sound. The bats makes sound. It makes sound towards the surroundings, towards its surroundings, and waves meets an object. So when it makes sounds, the waves will pass us in the air. The waves meets an object. So objects means it may be our wall or any fruit or any other bird or its prey. Supposed to say its prey, andre adra ondu ahara. To create echoes, to create an echoes. So these echoes bounce back. These echoes bounce back towards the bat. Okay, once again I will tell. Bats make sound. The waves meets an object to create echoes. So these echoes, once again, it will reaches towards the bats. So like this process, the bats are going to have, it's going to catch its food or have its food or identify its food. So it is, this process is called echolocation. This process is called echolocation. So bats, whale and dolphin are having echolocation. So this is about the bats, and whales and dolphins also having, they will use the same process, the echolocation, to catch its prey or to identify its prey. So this is about the sense of organs in animals. Just hold on students, we will move further. Well students, the next concept is animals also sleep. Animals also sleep. You know what is the meaning of sleeping? It is a process of taking rest. Yes, it is a process of taking rest for our body, to giving a rest for our body as well as for our mind. Yes, so animals also sleep. Just like us, even animals also sleep. So on the base of animals, some animals, so we have categorized the short period and the long period. Some of the animals sleep for very short period and some animals will sleep for a very long period. So it depends on the amount of food, the how much amount of food is going to take and how much energy it is going to conserve. So because of, on the basis of the amount of food and the conservation of energy, so the animals sleep short time and for a long time, or long shorter period and longer period. So amount of food, so animals eat large amount of food, they need more energy. So why they eat more food? Because it need more energy, so that's why it is going to have more. Andre kelavu pranigalige tumba aahara tinutte yenakandre adakke tumba shakti beku. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅದು ತುಂಬ ಆಹಾರನ ತಗೊಳುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಸ್ಲೀಪ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್, ಸಮ್ ದಿ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಎ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫುಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಲೀಪ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್. ಸೊ ಸಚ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್, ಹಾರ್ಸ್, ಕೌ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಡೇ ಟು ನೈಟ್, ದೀಸ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್. So after eating, it should be digest. Yes or no? So that's why it is not going to sleep for a long period. It is going to sleep for a very short period. And some animals such as lion, tiger and python, these type of animals will need to conserve energy. So that's why this type of animals sleeps longer period. Longer period. For example, tigers take rest nearly 16 hours, nearly 16 hours, and python sleeps for 20 hours. After having its meal, it is going to take rest for a very long time. Even bat, it is going to sleep for 20 hours in a day. So only 5 hours it is going to be active. So on the basis of the animals, how they are going to have food, means on the basis of amount of food and on the basis of to conservation of energy, animals sleep for short time and the long time. Hold on students, okay students, in your textbook page number 39 they have given animals behavior in sleeping place, how animals are going to sleep in the places where animals are going to sleep. See, animals behavior varies in sleeping time. The most of the animals sleep at the night, but animals like owl, bat and mice sleep during the daytime. Apart from this, animals behavior varies in sleeping place, means where animals are going to sleeping. Animals such as zebras, giraffe and elephant sleeps in the open fields, not in the bushes, not in the caves, in the bush, in the open fields. So animals such as the leopard sleeps on the tree branches, and seals and hippos sleeps under the water. The migratory bird sleeps while flying across the ocean. Moles and rabbits sleeps in the burrows. So like these animals are going to choose their places, like how we are going to sleep on the bed or on the mat. So like that, animals also going to choose its place where it is going to take rest. So some of the animals will take rest in caves, some of the animals in bushes, some of the animals in open fields, some of the species in water and branches of the trees, like monkeys, leopards, they prefer trees to take rest. I think this much is enough, students. So this is about the lesson number 8, searching for food. So just watch this video, this class video, once or twice. You are going to get an idea, and if it is any confusion, call us. Just read the lesson, read the textbook. You are going to understand the entire lesson. I think this much is enough. Thank you friends. Get back to your work hard. Very shortly you are going facing a term examination in upcoming days. So if you have any doubts, please contact us. So I will, along with this video, I will send some activities, means to work, HLS and SLS. Please stay safe, work hard. Thank you.